Good evening, everybody, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. There we go. Okay, well, that was unexpected. Sorry about that. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick look at what's going on with the forecast into the rest of the evening. And if you have any plans for travel tonight, it looks like the possibility of a few more showers and thunderstorms out across much of the area. We're seeing, again, some areas of light precipitation so far this evening. We'll take a look at what we're going to be expecting into the overnight hours coming up here in just a little bit. If you've never tuned in before, this is our video weather blog, exclusive video weather blog called Weather Overtime. Email address down here if there's anything you'd like to let us know about, whether it's pictures you've taken or questions about the forecast or anything else you'd like to see on here, please let us know. We would love to know more about that. Drop your location into the comments section. We're live on Periscope and Twitter right now and keeping you updated on what's going on with the forecast into the rest of the evening. We cover West Tennessee, we cover North Mississippi and Eastern Arkansas, everything below the Missouri boot heel and just above middle parts of Mississippi. The website address again here, WREG.com/weather, including all the social media networks that I'm on over there. Current in the backyard, 76 degrees with over an inch, 0.35 of rain in the News Channel 3 backyard. For tonight's forecast, lows back around 70, and high temperatures tomorrow in the bar down here going back to around the lower 80s with more chances of showers and thunderstorms right on into the rest of the early portion of Monday. Earthquakes, nothing really to report in about the last 24 hours. There was one just north of the Mid-South and another one sitting just right over to around the area of just outside the News Channel 3 viewing area into northwestern parts of Tennessee. We do get them occasionally in and around those particular areas. Much of what we see is, again, relatively light, roughly a 3-point magnitude or less, but we do occasionally still have them around and about the area, so we do still get the possibility of some of those earthquakes wandering on through parts of northwest Tennessee, but otherwise nothing major taking place at this time. This one was a 1.4 and happened at about 2:43 this afternoon, the one that you're looking at here in portions of northwest Tennessee. More information from the Center for Earthquake Research and Information or from the United States Geological Survey. Over the next few hours, again, temperatures remaining relatively steady, cooling off where there is going to be some rainfall, and winds are going to be out of the south, fairly light, 5 miles per hour or less. Chances of showers and thunderstorms will be with us pretty much throughout the rest of the evening and right on into the early portion of early Monday morning. This could be a bit of a problem for commute time tomorrow morning. We'll have updates on that forecast with Todd Demers early tomorrow, and Corey Ventura will have more on News Channel 3 Daybreak Traffic, so stay tuned for more on that. Let's go ahead and run the numbers and show you what we've got going on into the rest of the evening. Again, relatively quiet, not a lot expected, but we will be seeing these areas of showers and thunderstorms refire and reform throughout the rest of the evening, so they'll develop, drift, collapse, start back over again, and repeat the process throughout the course of the rest of the evening. So most of what we are going to be seeing at this time is going to be just these widely scattered late spring, pretty typical for this time of the season, chances of showers and thunderstorms out there, and that'll go right on in through early tomorrow morning. Right about the time we hit daybreak, we could be looking at the possibility of some more showers and thunderstorms redeveloping across portions of the area. No real rhyme or reason to them, just kind of haphazardly scattered across portions of the Mid-South, so please keep that in mind if you are going to be doing any traveling, especially early tomorrow morning. A little bit of extra time, a lot more space between you and the vehicles in front of you. Haste is going to be a big mistake tomorrow, especially if those roadways are wet, so please keep that in mind. And it looks like the rest of the day is going to be a fairly mild one with temperatures back into the mid to upper 70s to lower 80s by lunchtime. As you notice, again, throughout the entire Mid-South, we've got showers and thunderstorms just pretty well scattered all over the place. It's going to be a possibility of showers and thunderstorms in some locations. You may pick up something in Abbeville and not get anything down toward Oxford. You may get something in Ripley, Tennessee. You might not get anything in and around the Dyersburg area. Same thing, you may get something in Memphis proper and not get anything down toward South Haven. They'll be scattered like that all over the Mid-South area throughout the rest of the day into tomorrow. And right on into tomorrow afternoon and evening, that'll be the peak heating time of the day, and we'll also see more chances of those showers and thunderstorms continue to pop up across much of the Mid-South right on into tomorrow evening around News Channel 3 at 10 with Jim Jagger. So please keep that in mind if you have any outdoor plans throughout the rest of the day tomorrow. We also have the potential of some fog forming in the Mid-South. It doesn't really look like, again, too much at this time for right now, but morning we could early on see the possibility of less than a mile visibility going on around northwest Tennessee and then back into around portions of the rest of the area, fractions of a mile as we go toward daybreak. And then once the sun comes up, it's going to heat the atmosphere up, get more showers and thunderstorms going, but then also see the possibility of some of that patchy fog remain across the area. So we could be looking at 2.5 miles by rush hour in and around Olive Branch, and a little bit less than that in some portions of eastern Arkansas. But if you do have any plans for travel, that again is one more reason you need to get out and get going just a little bit earlier. 7-day forecast for the rest of the evening and into tonight. Temperatures for lows again back into the lower 70s. Before tomorrow, temperatures going back into the lower 80s with showers and thunderstorms possible throughout the day. Could be a lingering shower or thunderstorm on Tuesday morning. Doesn't really look like much right now, but it will be, again, the possibility of picking up some activity in the Mid-South into around the early morning hours of Tuesday. Afterwards, some drier air swoops on through, and that gives us some very nice conditions into the middle part of the week. Lower 80s, plenty of sunshine, dry conditions, so a very pleasant midweek coming up as we head into the first full week of June, running out of springtime, heading into summer pretty soon out there. And throughout the rest of the week, staying dry, but as we head toward, it looks like next week, we'll be looking at the possibility of more temperatures going very close up to about 90 degrees. So if we have the possibility of getting some hotter weather in here, enjoy the slightly cooler temperatures while you have the opportunity to do so. We'll take a look at the 10-day forecast coming up tonight on News Channel 3 at 10. Don't forget about Todd Demers. He'll have more on your forecast coming up bright and early tomorrow morning. And, of course, I'll have your complete forecast with Bob and Josh bright and early on Monday through Fridays on AM 730 Yahoo Sports Radio. And, of course, join me on all these social media networks. We'll keep you up to date on what's going on there. Time is just before 8 o'clock on Sunday evening. We'll have an update on your forecast coming up on the News Channel 3 Facebook page at 8 o'clock. Of course, we'll have News Channel 3 at 10. And, of course, also we'll be updating you throughout the course of the rest of the week. So stay tuned for more with News Channel 3. Again, questions, concerns, comments, ideas, if you got them. If there's something on here you'd like to see, we'd love to know about it, but psychic powers don't really work too well, so email is going to be your next best bet, austin.onek@wreg.com. If there's something you'd like to see on here, we'd love to know about it. We'd love to let you come back, have you come back again for this being your source of weather information on News Channel 3, whether it's on air or online. Let us know, and we'll see what we can do about that. Thanks for joining me for tonight's Weather Overtime. We'll have another update coming up tonight on News Channel 3 at 10, and in just a few minutes on Facebook from our News Channel 3 Facebook page. Thanks for joining me.